find someone who understands the life you live must be.
Hey sugar babies, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here and you have not yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button now. Don't forget to hit the bell right next to it so you can be notified every time I make a post. Today, guys, we are getting into another Extreme Cheapskates. I haven't done this quite a while on my channel. This is Man Heats Up Food in His Jacuzzi, which sounds all types of ratchet to me, but without further ado, let's get into it and see what Bruh has going on.
That online dating service, Todd was not paying for it, and I was paying for it. Red flags! I realized pretty quickly that he was different from anyone else I had dated before. One Christmas, Todd bought me Doritos and chocolate chips for Christmas. And
no.
I cried.
Yes, sis.
Hard.
And let me clock this right now, because it's not about the material things. That's not what Christmas is about. It shouldn't be, you know, about gifts or whatever. But at the same time, it's like, if you're going to give a gift, please do something better than Doritos and chocolate chips. Like, you could have made her a card, or I don't know, just repurpose that money that you spent for the Doritos and the chocolate chips. And I bet you it wasn't even like a family size bag. It probably was a personal size bag. And that's even more ratchet. But you could have done a little something. You could have got one of them little tiny bears or whatever from the dollar store and made her a card or something. If you just really didn't have the money or didn't want to spend it or something. Something better. Okay? Please stop. Please stop. Because the level of fuckery is killing me right now.
While she would sometimes joke and say that she was on a crazy train, you know, pun intended, since I drive trains, she got off the crazy train. But I'm running the train.
You should have money.
Straight down the track, and I can do whatever I want. Well, right now, I've got some clothes in Ziploc bags. I don't have to put them in the washing machine. It actually kills the bacteria by having them in here. That way I save on laundry detergent. I save on time.
No.
I don't have to reuse electricity to run my washing machine.
No. Putting your clothes in the freezer is not going to get rid of the stains. Okay? It's not going to get rid of the sweat that has been absorbed into the clothes. Okay? It's not going to get rid of the freaking dead skin cells that have now rubbed off onto your clothes. That's not how that works, sir. It's not how it works. That's ratchet.
I've had clothes since high school. Can you believe that? Okay, this is a pair of jeans. Okay, this pair here, I bought these 15 years ago. Look at that. Like brand new. Yeah, it's like I just bought them.
The average refrigerator uses around 350 kilowatts of electricity per year. By tightly packing his fridge with clothes, cookware, and canned goods,
why is the cookware in there?
Use by nearly 10%.
The refrigerator doesn't cycle on as much, and it doesn't produce or consume as much electricity. Just pack up your fridge with anything you can find. I don't care. I don't care that some people might think that some of my habits are over the top now.
Clearly you don't.
For God's sake, I mean, that's pretty cheap.
Otherwise, you would not be on national TV.
That's one of the things about Todd is he doesn't care about comfort. He cares about saving money.
There's no need for me to use the washing machine because it just costs too much money. I can just reuse the water right here.
No.
No.
No. No. First of all, this water probably it's supposed to have chlorine in it. That's how hot tubs work. You need to put chlorine in it. And then not only that, like your body's been in it. So then again, dead skin particles, like all types of stuff is in this water. And then if you're washing your clothes in there, like, are you draining it, or then are you getting into it and swimming like it's cute? Please stop. Please stop.
I'm able to wash my clothes in here. My clothes last for years.
From a real estate standpoint, hot tubs are considered personal property and do not affect the resale value of a home.
I just put a little bit of soup in my plastic container, and you'd be surprised at how quickly it heats up. I mean, people probably use their microwave every day.
But how...
And it adds up to almost $40 a month. It's almost free.
No.
Because my hot tub is not going to add any value to the house, I decided to use it for multi-purposes.
But if you got to pay to generate it, don't you? So you're hold up, whatever your name is, hold up. So you're heating your meals in here, you're washing your clothes, you're washing your nasty body. No. How is that sanitary? How is that sanitary? How are you washing your clothes when you just scrubbed all the dirt and nastiness off your body in here? No, make it make sense. It does not make sense. Are you draining this every day? Are you draining it in between the times that you wash your clothes and wash your body? No, you're not. It's disgusting and it's out of pocket. No.
Can turn off the hot water heater. This hot tub, I mean, this thing is a money saver. I mean, this is like a cash cow for me. I think it's a stroke of genius myself.
I think that you, of course, you would. Dad's free time is spent preserving the value of things that he has.
And the fact that people be engaged to these people, married to these people, is beyond me.
I'm trying to get the best deal I can. This car is 10 years old, and you would not know that by looking at it. If I were to sell my car, I think I could probably get $3,000 for fair condition and $6,000 for good condition. Easily. I've got plastic not only on the dashboard and on the steering wheel, but I've got it on the seats, I've got it on the floor mats. Most cars get a lot of that weathered look, and a lot of the sun just bleaches a lot of the plastic, but I don't get that in my car. My car is just perfect. I mean, it's as good as the day I bought it.
I have no idea how Todd is able to drive in that car with all that plastic.
Out of pocket.
He has no pride.
Not a speck, not an ounce, not a drop.
I was drying some clothes in the dryer, and I thought, why am I spending
no
money?
Shame.
Well, I could just, you know, put them in the back of my car and
of course
he
does.
I did it a couple times, and it worked like a champ.
I think the clothesline in the car is ridiculous. Todd can afford to dry his clothes in the damn dryer. Oh, I swore.
The average car, and on a warm day, can soar up to about 150 degrees. It only takes about 2 or 3 hours for my clothes to dry in the back seat.
Air drying saves Todd 45 cents per load of laundry, or approximately $100 a year.
And, I mean, to me, this is like really the only way to go. Each of my stops each day is contingent on timing in order to get the best deals and the best bargains. Grocery stores usually discount near expired food toward the end of the day.
So Todd has this thing where he goes to the store and he peruses the fish and meats and looks at the dates. So he'll buy all the fish that's on clearance that they're about to throw out, and he eats that. That's disgusting.
Absolutely,
100%. Cheap. When I find a good deal, I feel really good. It makes my day. Any good deals on seafood today?
I do. What you looking for?
Anything that's gonna be past its expiration date? Do you have anything that's old? Anything expired?
You know, if the packages are broken open, I'll take a look. There you go. There's a deal.
See that one broken?
Yeah. You can have it for half price.
What about this one? This one's looking a little brown.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll take that for 99 cents. How's that sound?
That's kind of cheap.
What do you give me on that one? I see a lot. That one looks like it's been opened up.
That's cool.
99 cents. I'll take that for 99 cents.
What is this 99 cents?
How is he making this?
Back in the 1950s, okay?
Well, I'm just looking for a deal. How old is this? Is there an expiration date on this one?
Ratchet.
99 cents.
Go for it.
I estimate that I probably save about $75 a month on expired groceries that most people don't want. And I can save me up to about $900 a year. When I'm satisfied knowing that it's the lowest price I can get, then I buy it all. Throw it in my freezer, and yeah, I'm living like a king. Do you have any free samples going on?
I got chocolate for the women customers, so go ahead.
Getting something for free, it's great. I can't think of anything else more exciting.
Okay, I'm gonna stop there right there. I can't. I just can't. Like, it's so ghetto and ratchet that I just can't. It makes my skin crawl. Like, if you go somewhere and you ask them if they accept food stamps, or we're at a grocery store and you're trying to, like, haggle prices and stuff with somebody, like, no. Like, if the price is what it is, this is not a yard sale. These people have a business to run. The price is what it is. Okay, don't be haggling stuff. Unless it's like, for example, I make these fairy pot things, and I usually crack one side off the terracotta pot to decorate the inside. Now, if I go to Walmart, say, and they already have one that's cracked, nobody else is going to buy that because it's a cracked pot. They need the whole pot to make their plants or whatever. I might say, can I, you know, get a discount because it's broken? That's one thing. It's broken. You literally, nobody else is going to buy this. You're going to have to throw it out, and that's lost money for you guys. You might as well get a little bit of a coin that way. But most stores, if the meat is about to expire or it expires that day, they will put a markdown on it. But if don't try to haggle the markdown, bro, like, oh, that makes my skin crawl. Anyway, that's gonna be it for this video. Let me know what else you guys would like to see down in the comments. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And until next time, you guys, stay sweet, stay safe, stay blessed, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.